Now we're ready to insert a new slide. My next slide is about the goal of the workshop, and I have a picture I'd like to include. I'll just click the New Slide command, and although several of these layouts will work, I think I'll just click this To Content option and try it. I've copied my text from another document, so I'll just paste it here in one of the placeholders. This looks okay, but I think I'd like to try another layout. To do this, just make sure the slide you want to change is selected in the Slide pane, and click the Layouts command. A menu appears with your options. They are the exact same layout options that you see when you insert a new slide. The Layout command just changes the layout of an existing slide. Here, I think this content with caption layout will work, so just click it to select it, and you can see how the slide layout changes. Now, I'll just type in Goal in the small title placeholder, and I think this will work just fine. So you can see how the Layout command lets you change the way the placeholders are arranged on the slide and how your information looks in the presentation. You can see this really clearly if you select your first slide and change its layout. Now, click the Layout command and you can see the title slide layout is selected. If you change that to Title and Content, or to Section Heading, you can easily see how layouts work. Let's go back to our original layout. I think it looks the best. There may be times when you want to copy, delete, or move a slide. To copy a slide, just select it in the Slide pane. Click the Copy command on the Home tab. Then click inside the pane wherever you want the copy of the slide to appear. You'll see a horizontal insertion point appear. Now, just click the Paste command on the Home tab, and the copied slide will appear. You can see we have a new slide 4 that looks just like slide 2. As with most Microsoft software, there are several ways you can do tasks. You can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl and C to copy the slide and Ctrl and V to paste it. If you want to delete a slide, all you need to do is select it in the pane on the left if you are in normal view, and then click the Delete command on the Home tab. If you prefer to use your keyboard, you can just click the Delete key on the keyboard. In addition to copying and deleting slides, you may need to move them. For example, I decided I want my goal slide to appear after my title slide. To move a slide, just select the one you want to move. Left-click and drag the slide to where you want it to appear. You'll see the insertion point appear, and then you can release the mouse button. You can see now that my goal slide appears after my title slide. See, that wasn't difficult to do. I showed you how to copy, delete, and move slides around while we were in normal view, but you can do this when you are in slide sorter view also. In the bottom right corner, you have your page layouts commands. Normal is the default view and where you will create your slides in the center, and all the slides will appear on the left in the pane vertically. But sometimes, it's good to look at your slideshow in slide sorter view. To do this, just click the slide sorter icon. Now your slides are presented horizontally. When you're working with many slides, sometimes it's good to see it in this view because you can see more slides at a time. You can copy, delete, and move slides from this view also, but the insertion point is vertical, not horizontal. Let's go back to normal view. Now we're ready to save the presentation. Just click the Microsoft Office button. If we had already saved this presentation before, we would select Save from the list, but since this is the first time, we are saving it and we want to save it as something other than the default name, Then we need to select Save As from the menu. We have several options for how we can save it. If you're going to use the presentation on a computer that does not have PowerPoint 2007, you can choose to save it as a compatible file, but we'll just save it as a 2007 PowerPoint presentation by selecting this first option. The Save As dialog box appears, and we can select where on our computer we want to save it. I want it on my desktop. Now I can enter a file name. I'll call it Workshop. And click Save. And you can see the file name has been changed. Now, you've really learned the basics of starting a presentation, working with slides, and saving the file. The best way to feel more comfortable with these tasks is to practice. So go ahead, give it a try.